All right, let's get to a developing story, something we've been watching all night long, one of the deadliest mining accidents in the country. This is a story coming to us from Turkey this morning, where we have just learned the death toll has risen to 232.
And there are hundreds of people who are still missing. Steve Patterson has been tracking the latest developments. He's live now in the newsroom. Steve.
Yeah, guys, that number in the last about 20 minutes jumped from 205 to 232. We were fearing that that would happen, and it did. Still more than 200, or around 200 after that adjusted number, missing after an explosion, and then it was a fire in a coal mine. And as Megan mentioned, this is south of Istanbul, Turkey. I want to get right to some new video of the rescue effort from this morning. This is sort of the dramatic scene outside of the mine. This comes from last night as well. Survivors being rescued one by one. The blast could not have happened at a worse time. This was during a shift change, which meant that more people were in the mine than would typically be. 787 were inside of the mine in all. Now, according to a Turkish energy official, 363 miners have been rescued, but again, 232 dead, still around 200 missing. That figure is a little bit fuzzy at this point, but the fear is that just as we saw in the last 20 minutes, the search for survivors continues, only to show us that the death toll will rise, and we're thinking that that might still happen as the morning goes on. This story continues to develop. If any new information does come into our newsroom, I'll make sure that you know it at home. For now, guys, I'll send it right back over to you.
Okay, thanks, Steve. Well, it was just yesterday morning where we told you about two miners who died during a collapse in West Virginia. This happened Monday night. The men were doing something called retreat mining. That's where workers mine coal and then leave pillars behind to support the mine roof. The company says that a, quote, ground failure trapped the workers inside.